first one is called Jenny's Wedding. The second one, the Virginia. Some people call it the Virginian. And then followed by a really called Garrett Fenry Green, named after their flying hyper. Thank you.
Cardo, agus Tiana Comhali in Fin. Be cure we flourish up in Walla Dinkish. Anish, Tom Fain agus Mugurfurka, Kupla a Shaid, Cloda agus Emer, Contrice Lanon a Hind Deal. Moss Murphy's, John Johartnitz, agus Shane Stanhills. The Chunda Connor and Guitar, O'Connor Club.
Do you want to see the difference with Aim Dead Zone? I've got my stream up.
I'm actually fixing to have to run and go eat dinner with my family, so.
No problem, man.
Sorry.
It's no problem. Incredible disappointment. How dare you eat and sustain your life?
Yeah, pretty much.
You're in another time zone, right?
Definitely. Oh shit, I gotta call back to the States too.
I was pretty pumped. I was, I had Sprint, and I went down to South America, and Sprint was free in South America. Calling, texting, everything, pretty nice. And a gig of data.
If I don't call back to the bank here soon, my wife's gonna be pissed. Telling her I'm gonna get to it. It ain't happening.
Well, luckily it's only 11 o'clock central here, so.
Yeah, I was supposed to do it at 8 o'clock central.
Yeah, I went ahead and posted. I think I can get a couple of people to load up my stream on Fridays and Saturdays on a second computer just to inflate my numbers.
Yeah, but only a couple of people, that ain't gonna really help. I don't think, will it?
Oh yeah, man, even like five people. Because, I mean, I load my second box on there to chat, so that's one. So if there's like, you know, three or four others, that gets me up from zero to like five, and that's that. A lot of people, there's so many people that do DayZ and watch DayZ that helps significantly. Like when the last update came out, 0.60 on experimental, 195 unique people tried to load into the servers.
Interesting.
I mean, that's just, you know, there's people saying DayZ standalone's dead and all that. Well, I just think it's a long process. don't know, like, I got some friends, they're playing on a 30-person server, but there's only 13 people on the server. And, you know, I'd much rather, we're in a large world, so I'd much rather play on a 60-person almost full for the interaction.
Yeah. Understandable.
Yeah, but these guys are being idiots. I was on this low pop server to meet up with them, and they're running in the opposite direction, so I'm probably gonna drop it and get on my big role playing server.
Yeah. Hate it when people do that.
It's no big deal, man. I mean, DayZ, it's hard to find people regardless. Gosh darn, 723 DayZ hours.
Jeez.
Well, I mean, Steam counts it if you leave it logged on, of course. Just in the server choice, but still. All right, I'm going to jump on another server. I'm getting on a role-playing TeamSpeak, seeing if I can get my app in and stuff like that. So,
all right, have fun.
Appreciate it. Thank you for helping me get my form fixed up. That was really bizarre.
No problem.
disconnected. Connected. User left your channel. Channel switched.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey, I'm brand new. I just put in my application for the whitelist weekend.
Yeah.
How long does something like that usually take to get looked at? A week or two?
I'm here for 4 months.
Oh, they haven't looked at your application for 4 months?
Yes, they have. It's just some things going on with, don't worry.
One second.
If you wrote everything correctly and you did everything like you wanted to and everything is done good, you will be accepted soon.
So if yours is different, how long does it usually take normally?
Sorry? You must make normal application for me. I've been here for 4 months because in first application I wrote my character's age, like 20 something, and in real life I'm 14. And that messed up some things, and I am searching for admins to talk to.
All right, thank you.
Channel switched.
Oh God.
Hello.
Oh. You trying to get on?
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I just put in an application process. I was just inquiring.
Shit.
Doing what? Whitelist applications?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I want to join this server so I get some, do some more role playing and get some more people to view my stream. I think I've got one of the best, like, DayZ streams.
Are you streaming right now?
Yeah, I am. I stream with Aim Dead Zone in first person and third person, so. I just
What's
put
your
in
stream?
The DayZ streamer. I just put in my application, so that's why I popped over here to support. I thought maybe there'd be someone to ask, like, how long it normally takes.
You on Twitch right now?
Roger. Have you seen streaming with Dame Dead Zone?
Yep.
Completely different.
I don't know what you just said. I'm just listening to music. I'm sorry.
I said, have you seen streaming with Aim Dead Zone? It's completely different.
No, what is that?
It's just a setting in game, and nobody uses it because it's more difficult, but I think it adds to RP and everything.
You're live now. Are you using it right now?
Yeah, okay. So my character doesn't move. You see, my character's not moving, it's just his gun. Where if I go more, then my character starts to turn, but it's got this Aim Dead Zone here where you can move the gun around. And you can really see it in first person here where the gun just moves without my character moving, and then you go to the edge, and then it moves more, but... And my, target will be not in the middle of the screen. When you have it off, all you have to do is put the middle of the screen at somebody and shoot. But it takes a little more skill and finesse to actually like line up the shot because the mouse pointer is all over the place.
Looks cool. I'm watching it. Playing before?
Oh yeah, I've been. What do you mean before what?
Like the what, server restart.
Oh yeah, I was on underground.
Like made it whitelisted.
Roger. Yeah. Yes, I was. That's why I came in and did the whitelist. I guess they did that because it was getting full.
I have no idea. No idea. Maybe. Okay. How long were you on? Did you kill anyone today?
No. I didn't. I actually didn't run into anybody during the entire time. I was on, I don't know, hour and a half or something.
Counter-Strike won't load for me. Hurt. Counter-Strike is not running. It is running.
And I'm lost in the woods.
for prize to get back my friend here.
I haven't played Counter-Strike in a while. I've been playing Overwatch and DayZ mainly. Yeah, generally, the reason people don't use the aim dead zone is because they say it's too difficult. So you know my response to that. Starts with a puss and ends with an E.
Pussy?
Well, yeah, of course.
I never even knew that was in the game.
Oh, yeah. Oh man, it used to be in the game for the flashlight, and they took it off, and I'm so pissed, because it was perfect, because you could just, have you played Alan Wake?
No.
I
heard that game's good.
Yeah, it is good, and you can, you know, you...
Who's this?
It's Runty.
Why, hello Runty, how are you?
I am doing good. We were just discussing some game options and some ways to increase the RP ability of DayZ. Mainly aim dead zone.
Oh, brilliant. Dead zone?
Aim dead zone, which I think is brilliant. And nobody uses it. I forget what we were talking about. Oh, yeah. So you used to be able to just look straight and then move your flashlight around independent of where your character was facing. So it really, really helped a lot. It was like Alan Wake, and that was really cool. And they took it out, which pisses me off because it's just an option you can turn off and on with Aim Dead Zone. So I don't know why they'd remove it. I've been kind of petitioning to get it added back on. Have you seen, whoever just jumped in, have you seen streaming with Aim Dead Zone?
Surprise? Oh, I don't know where he went. I don't think he has. This will take forever. I'm gonna have to go to bed soon. I have to freak work tonight.
Yeah, I'm streaming all day and night, so it's my weekend. Hey, I just realized I found the payload mask, and it's 4th of July, so that's actually perfect. I've been wearing it all day for the weekend. I think it has a tactical advantage, the aim dead zone, more than just the roleplay ability and the look of it. I think it's got gameplay help. Because if you think Counter-Strike, so Counter-Strike is very fast, very, you know, headshot-oriented. When you do a 180 on Counter-Strike or an FPS, your screen's moving the entire time. Well, when I do a 180 in DayZ, my screen is going to stop moving before yours, and so I'll be able to have a steady shot. Then I'm just lining up my mouse. I'm not, you know, my screen is steady and you're able to see and distinguish things because you're not moving, and I think it's a huge tactic.
I never even knew that was in the game, dude.
So are you here waiting for the same thing I'm assuming we're here waiting for?
Whitelist?
Yep.
Yeah, it is shooting the shit about aim dead zone, that's it.
Yeah. We were playing, we were rocking out, we were starting to build a small community for survivors to come and, you know, feel safe. And then all of a sudden we get, bam, you're white, you need to be whitelisted.
I think it's just it's just the weekend because of the holiday, I think. It says whitelist weekend.
Yeah, it makes sense. But I think they were also talking about doing it more permanently, I think.
I would like that. It would allow more compliance to the rules.
See, I don't know. I'm kind of conflicted about that, to tell you the truth.
Conflicted about whitelisting or rules?
Well, the whitelisting. Well, I guess it would technically be both, but, you know. Because the way it is right now, I personally like this server better than, say, like DayZ RP, because in that, it's like, it's so strict in how the rules are set up and, you know, the way that you have to go about getting whitelisted, that it kind of takes, like, it's more forced RP as opposed to, like they say on here, it's more organic.
Oh, definitely. I got banned off of DayZ RP because I forgot one thing in my application. Like, I did a perfect application, and they asked me to change something, and when I changed it, I forgot one thing. And so I can never apply again. It's just ridiculous. And then...
Yeah, we're in the same boat, man. I know the feeling. I applied, I fucked up with one thing, I had to fix it, and then from there, it spiraled out of downhill, and I don't have time for that shit, so...
Yeah, and then that whole... forced no kill, so that just means people can run around, do whatever they want, and they know they're not going to get shot. How's that role playing? You know what I mean?
Yeah,
you need to be scared of death.
Yeah. Which is nice because, you know, like we've had multiple instances of just running into people and talking about stuff, but we've also been shot at, you know, so like there's still that fear there, but it's not overly abundant with, say, a public server. Like, you're more apt to run into some friendly people than you are people just shooting at you, but you still have the chance of running into somebody that's just going to shoot at you because of where you are.
And the first person just...
Well, yeah, that and... I'm from Spearhead community, so... First person is like... We that's all we do is hardcore servers, so it's always first person, and...
Oh, so...
Trying to...
Spearhead's Sorry. Running DayZ Underground?
No. DayZ Underground is separate. I'm a dev for those guys over there. And when 0.60 came out, I decided to pick it up and play again. And this was like one of the only first-person servers that actually seemed like it was, you know, good.
Well, I was in a server today that was saying to join the Arrowhead TeamSpeak. I don't remember which one that one is. Yeah, Arrowhead.
Yeah. No, Spearhead is the one I'm from.
Gotcha.
Devil Dog Gamer, all that. I don't really know. It's mostly a Arma 3 community.
Yeah, I'm doing RP to boost my stream. I pretty much only do RP. Play RP and all that stuff, so I'm I want to get into that more. I see DayZ as a content creation game.
Yeah, for sure. Huh? DayZ will be a lot better when they basically allow for mod creation to it.
To a point. I like the vanilla of it so far.
Yeah, no, I know what you mean, but there's going to be some mods that are really good for DayZ, you know, that are going to expand upon Bohemia's weaknesses.
Base building.
Yeah, base building, their weak-ass codec for voice. Like, if we can get, like, a task force radio
DayZ. They're already fixing the sounds and everything like that. Have you heard the new sounds that they're doing in Arma, then they're going to try to port it over to DayZ? And they sound really good.
Yeah, well, that's... I play a shit ton of Arma, so, I mean, I'm a dev for Arma. I make mods and servers and shit for that. So
well, the DayZ devs are gonna try to use that new I forget what that new sound pack is for Arma, but they're gonna try to use it.
Yeah, and it's a lovely sound pack, man. It is amazing.
Just the progression to 0.60 has been great. It's just been really good.
It's just a shame, because 0.60 is what should have initially been released, you know?
But then I wouldn't have had a year to play with it, you know? I mean, that's alpha. 0.60 is what beta should be, at least. So, I don't know.
Yeah.
I mean, there's too many people talking crap about how buggy DayZ is, and it's like, look, you got it at the earliest you possibly could to join in the development, you know? But
right. No, I mean, it's buggy, but it's, you know, there's that fucking box that you have to click every time you start it up that says, I understand this is early access. Like, you know, it should pretty much make sense to you that there's going to be bugs.
Well, the thing is, I like it because we're going to have so much a deeper understanding of DayZ and the metrics, like how everything works, because we've been here from the beginning.
Yeah.
You know, all the little systems like the food and the starvation and the cold and all that stupid stuff.
Yeah.
And heck, now's the time to build a following of streamers and all that, you know, to build a following for streamers.
Oh, yeah. I've thought about streaming, but I don't really have the time for it. It's tough when you have two kids and a wife and shit going on all the time.
Yeah, I understand that, man. I just have a blast with it. There's nothing else. I'm doing it just for fun, not to make money, you know? That's not... I just want people to join in. And I'm a big guild player. I play with my guild. And my guild doesn't play this at all, so I really want to get them playing.
What are you up play?
Oh, I was saying I'm in a guild. I play with my guild a lot. I play Overwatch right now. Overwatch and DayZ are my main games.
I'm beginning to think that nobody's ever to come talk to us.
When I was not in that channel, I couldn't see that there was anybody in the channel, if that makes sense.
Yeah, no, I know that. It might just be your TeamSpeak setting, though.
No, I mean, I think it's the channel setting where they can't...
Hello!
Hello!
Yeah,
I see you there with the green backpack. Hello. I see you.
Sorry, person again. Hello.
Bastion Orton.
Why are you worried about the color of my backpack?
Couldn't see us in here. I think I think the admins see
I'm
it.
I'm not.
Have, like, the power
I'm kind of upset.
Right.
I'm about to have to commit suicide.
See, I can see everybody.
Dude,
can you
don't
see me?
Don't commit suicide, dude.
Don't commit suicide, dude.
I mean, don't do it.
Well, I'm in the floor of this greenhouse where I'm spawning in and out on every server.
There is a salvation
farm. Hey, dude,
everybody
back
is welcome as long as they're non-hostile.
Like, lay down, back up, stand up, and vault, and try that. V. I got a guy stuck in it.
How do you roll?
I got a guy stuck in it.
Roll is lay down and Q
roll
and E.
Lay down and Q and E.
Got stuck in a fucking house.
Got stuck in a fucking house.
I try backing up as far as you possibly
can.
And then stand up.
Stand up.
Can you see me at all?
Negative.
Negative.
I can hear you.
Hear you.
You know, it's kind of weird spawning in and then there's somebody walking around on my head. It was weird.
You want me to shoot you?
You want me to shoot you?
Can you see me? To shoot me?
No, I don't know what corner you're at.
No, I don't know what corner.